Pakistan women, 92 for 2 after 14 overs, chasing 133 to beat the West Indies in the third T20 International, currently on at the National Stadium in Karachi. Aisha Zar, Zafar, 19, and Muniba Ali, 12, are the batters back in the pavilion. Sidra Amin, 53, and Captain Nida Dar, 6 are the not-out batters. Earlier, the West Indies made 132 for 5 in their 20 overs. Their captain, Hayley Matthews, led the charge. She got 68 off 49 balls with 10-4. She got support from Shemaine Campbell, 31, Chedi Nation, 10, and Chanel Henry, 11. Not-out Fatima Sana took 2 wickets for Pakistan. The West Indies lead the series. President of the Jamaica Cricket Association, Dr. Donovan Bennett, says his administration will be pushing to widen and strengthen the pool of female players in Jamaica. Dr. Bennett says he hopes to meet with the president of ISA to discuss establishing a girls' league at a secondary level.
What we have in female cricket in Jamaica and across the entire Caribbean is a sort of ad hoc thing. You drive around and you ask about female cricketers. Do we have a cricketer that you know of that you can recommend to us? No. We have got to get to the stage where the females play the game at an early age. I am going to ask ISO, and I'm going to implore on him the fact that we need to start a female competition in the high schools. I don't think that, you know, we'll get every high school to play, but if we can get 5 or 6 or 7 high schools to start playing the female game, it will grow. It will make a big difference.
Dr. Bennett also agrees in principle with the suggestion that each local club should have a female team.
But we have to take it stage by stage. You know, there are just not enough female cricketers present now who know the game or can play the game or who are interested in the game, where we would be able to have all the clubs and parishes playing in a competition. That is impossible. The only way you would get there is to expose the game to the primary school children, and then in a couple of years we can push it along on the 15 competition, then on the 17 competition, then on the 19. Then we go to the clubs and parishes with their senior teams. So it's going to take a little time, but if you're going to do it, we can't do it in an ad hoc way. We have to do it in a very systematic and a thoughtful way.
Dr. Donovan Bennett, president of the Jamaica Cricket Association. Jamaica's under-17 women's football team will host their Trinidad and Tobago counterparts in 2 international friendlies at the UWIC Captain Horace Burrell Centre of Excellence at the weekend. The first game is set for Friday, game 2 on Sunday. The teams are using the games as part of preparation for the CONCACAF Championship in 2025. Trinidad and Tobago will play a club team on Tuesday. 2 of the old firms in local football, Waterhouse and Arnett Gardens, booked their spots in the semifinals of the Rare Nephew Jamaica Premier League on Monday night. Javane Bryan with his league-equaling 16th goal of the season and Andre Fletcher with his 12th netted for Waterhouse to beat Tivoli Gardens 2-0 in the second leg of their quarterfinal tie at Sabina Park to advance 3-1 on aggregate. Assistant coach Damien Gordon gave credit to his team for sticking to the game plan.
We just always take a humble step for everything. And tonight we did that. I think we took our chances very well. I still think that we had some more chances but we could have capitalized on, but we're still grateful. And I just want to send a word of prayer for that player today that got injured. And I hope he's at the hospital. And I also praying for the doctors to do an excellent job with him. But again, it's football. At South Tivoli, they really pressed us today. And I think they also forced us in terms of how well we look defensively.
That's the Waterhouse assistant coach Damien Gordon, and the player to which Gordon referred in that clip is Nikalia Fuller of Tivoli, who suffered a broken leg and went to the hospital. In the other second leg quarterfinal, Arnett Gardens with a 90th minute goal from captain Fabian Reed defeated Portmore United 1-0 to progress 2-1 on aggregate. Arnett's coach is Xavier Gilbert.
And we knew that it was just a matter of time. You know, we had to maintain the sustained pressure, and we continue to do so. We continue to plug away, and we finally got it in the end. Happy for them. I think they really deserve it. It's a huge boost heading into the semifinal. They should be confident. And we're just going to go back, recover, and get ready for the next game.
Xavier Gilbert, coach of Arnett Gardens. Sunday's semifinals will see Arnett facing Cavalier and Waterhouse against champions Mount Pleasant Academy, both games to be played at Sabina Park. The United States and Mexico have withdrawn their joint bid to host the 2027 Women's World Cup and will instead focus on bidding for the tournament in 2031. It comes less than 3 weeks before the hosts were to be chosen at a FIFA Congress in Bangkok, Thailand on May 17. The remaining bids are from Brazil and a joint one from Germany, Belgium and the Netherlands. The U.S. Soccer and Mexican Federation said their 2031 bid will call for equal investment as a men's tournament in a, quote, historic first. The revised bid will allow U.S. soccer to build on the learnings and success of the 2026 World Cup, better support their host cities, expand the partnership and media deals, and further engage with fans so they can host a record-breaking tournament in 2031. The U.S., Mexico, and Canada are hosting the next FIFA Men's World Cup. France, well, they've registered a record number of imported dengue cases just 3 months before the start of the Paris 2024 Olympic Games. The Paris 24 Olympic Games will be held July 26 to August 11, while the Paralympics will run August 28 to September 8. There have been 1,700 cases across the country since the start of the year, and president of the Jamaica Olympic Association, Christopher Samuda, says it's proving a cause for concern ahead of the spectacle is that it's just around the corner.
Paris is contending with challenges which are not uncommon to games, but an increase recently in the number of dengue imported cases raises the temperature. I am, however, confident that the French public health authorities have the wherewithal to prevent it from rising to a fever pitch and posing a real risk to the games.
Samuda says the Jamaica Olympic Association is closely monitoring the matter.
Our medical team is quite experienced in preventive and diagnostic medicine and care. We must nevertheless guard against overreacting and panic attacks, which inflame the situation when there are dying embers. The health and safety of athletes, coaches, and managers are paramount for the jury, and in that regard, we will keep a watch and never sleep. Our protocols dictate that before traveling, personal doctors should evaluate and, if satisfied, provide a clean bill just to ensure that there are no underlying conditions that would predispose a person to succumbing to existing health risks in the country hosting the games.
President of the Jamaica Olympic Association, Christopher Samuda. Finally, in sports at this time, LeBron James and the Los Angeles Lakers were knocked out of the NBA playoffs as the Denver Nuggets completed a 4-1 series win in the Western Conference. In Game 5 of the best-of-seven series, the defending champion Nuggets won a tense encounter 108-106. Jamal Murray scored 32 points, including the winner, with just 3.6 seconds left when the scores were tied. James's 30 points and 11 assists were in vain for the Lakers. The NBA's all-time leading point scorer was chasing his fifth title and his first with the Lakers since 2020, but when asked about his future, James would not confirm whether he had played his last game for the Lakers.
I'm not going to answer that.
Don't have an answer to your first question, to be honest. I haven't given it much thought. Obviously, at some point, I'll sit down with Rich, my agent, and sit down with my family and see what's best. What's best for my career. So, you know, we'll cross that when we need to. How taxing is very taxing. Mentally, physically, spiritually, everything. I mean, to be able to just play this game alone and then to try to play at a high level is very taxing. It's a lot of dedication, a lot of hard work, and a lot of long hours. You know, it's very taxing, but, you know, it's rewarding.
LeBron James, he said that after spending some time with his family, he'll travel to Las Vegas for a USA basketball training camp ahead of the Olympic Games. Elsewhere in the Western Conference, Oklahoma also progressed to the last eight with a 97-89 win over New Orleans. In the Eastern Conference, Boston edged closer to the next round. They took a 3-1 advantage in their playoff series with Miami. They won the fourth game 102-88, but were dealt an injury concern as center Kristaps Porzingis limped off the court with a calf strain shortly before halftime and did not come back. And finally, did say finally, yeah, but one more. Top seed Iga Swiatek fought back from a set down against Beatriz Haddad-Maye to book her place in the Madrid Open semifinals. Swiatek needed just 2 hours and 30 minutes to wrap up a 4-6, 6-6 win against the Brazilian. It was the first time the world's number one dropped a set in the tournament.